Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to this ETAP tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design load flow analysis in ETAP software. For this purpose I have taken an example from the book Power System Analysis by Hadi Sadat, chapter 6, example 6.7 as shown here. Consider the figure of the example, which consists of a generator at bus 1 and consists of three transmission lines with their impedances given in per unit. Among three buses, bus 1 is operating as slack bus, whereas bus 2 and 3 are operating as PQ buses consisting of loads. We have to determine the phasor values of the voltage at the load buses 2 and 3 as well as slack bus real and reactive power. Furthermore, we have to find the power flows and line losses of the system too. The mathematical solution of this example can be found in the Hadi Sadat book. For your convenience, I have uploaded the example solution as well as ETAP model in the form of link in the description section of this video. You can download it from there. Let's start. You can see ETAP screen is shown here. Click on this button to open a new project. Write here any name of your choice. You can see it shows here two systems, one for 60 Hz and other for 50 Hz. You can choose it according to your requirements. Otherwise, keep this setting as it is and press OK. Now it asks about username. You can use any username and press OK. Again, click on OK. Wait for a few seconds. You can see ETAP has created new empty project. To design the load flow analysis, look at the figure. At the first stage, we need generator for slack bus. The slack bus has the voltage of 1.05 per unit with phase angle of 0 degree. Now come to ETAP screen again. Bring the generator in the model from here. Paste it anywhere on the screen. Now click on this generator and press Ctrl plus R to rotate it in your desired direction. Now bring the bus in the model from here. Paste it here. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Connect this generator with this bus 1. Double click on this generator block. Make it swing generator by clicking on swing in the operation mode. Now click on rating icon to insert the other values. As we know that actual voltage as well as slack bus power is not given for this example, therefore you can choose any random values. In this case, I am choosing 1.05 kV as the voltage value and 10 MW as the slack bus initial power. Furthermore, you can notice that here it asks about the voltage in percentage. Therefore, write here 105% because 1.05 per unit slack bus voltage will be equal to 105% in percentage. Now double click on this bus to insert its data. As the bus 1 is connected with the generator, therefore the data in bus 1 is directly added here. This is the advantage of ETAP software. Therefore, no need to put here any value, just press OK. Look at the figure again, it may be noted that bus 2 and 3 both are operating as load buses. The load buses have always the voltage of 1 per unit and phase angle of 0 degree. Now come to ETAP screen again, bring the bus in the model from here, paste it here and rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Now double click on this bus to insert its data. As the bus 2 is operating as load bus, therefore write here 1 kV as the nominal voltage. It may be noted that this voltage is chosen arbitrary. Similarly, repeat the procedure to bring another bus from here in the model and paste it here. Now double click on this bus to insert its data. As the bus 3 is operating as load bus, therefore write here 1 kV as the nominal voltage. It may be noted that this voltage is again chosen arbitrary. At this stage, we have successfully inserted the bus data of the example. Now we need to insert the transmission line data of the example. For this purpose, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 1 to bus 2 has the resistance of 0.02 and reactance of 0.04 per unit. Now come to model again. Bring this impedance block from here in the model and paste it here to represent the transmission line. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R and connect it in between bus 1 and bus 2. Now double click on this block to insert the transmission line data. In the rating section, put 2 here in the resistance value and 4 in the reactance value. Write 1 here in the base kV. This 1 kV we have chosen arbitrary for the whole model. Friends, you may be confused why I have inserted 2 and 4 here. It may be noted that resistance and reactance inserted here is in the percentage. Therefore, 0.02 per unit and 0.04 per unit when converted into percentage equals to 2 and 4. Look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 1 to bus 3 has the resistance of 0.01 and reactance of 0.03 per unit. Now come to model again. Bring this impedance block from here in the model and paste it here. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R and connect it in between bus 1 and bus 3. Now double click on this block to insert the transmission line data. In the rating section, put 1 here in the resistance value and 3 in the reactance value. Write 1 here in the base kV. This 1 kV we have chosen arbitrary for the whole model. Look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 2 to bus 3 has the resistance of 0.0125 and reactance of 0.025 per unit. Now come to model again. Bring this impedance block from here in the model and paste it here. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R and connect it in between bus 2 and bus 3. Now double click on this block to insert the transmission line data. In the rating section, put 1.25 here in the resistance value and 2.5 in the reactance value. Write 1 here in the base kV and press OK. Look at the figure again. Now we have to connect the load at bus 2. It may be noted that the load connected on bus 2 is 256.6 MW and 110.2 MVAR. Therefore, come to model again, bring this load block from here in the model and paste it here to represent the load. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R and connect it here. Now double click on this block to insert the load data. In the name plate section, write here 256.6 MW and 110.2 MVAR respectively. In the load type section, click on this cursor and drag it to 100%. It is necessary, otherwise the results will be wrong. Friends, ETAP software has the advantage that when you insert the load data, it directly calculates its full load current, power factor as well as total apparent power as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that the load connected on bus 3 is 138.6 MW and 45.2 MVAR. Now come to model again. Bring this load block from here in the model, paste it here and connect it here. Now double click on this block to insert the load data. In the nameplate section, write here 138.6 MW and 45.2 MVAR respectively. In the load type section, click on this cursor and drag it to 100%. At this stage, our model is completed. Now we can run the simulation. To run the load flow analysis, first click on this button to activate the load flow analysis mode. When you click on this button, another new window will appear as shown here. Now run the load flow analysis by clicking on this button. Now it asks you about the name of the output file. Choose any name of your choice and press OK. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of this model. However, it seems that this result is difficult to understand. It is because the result is displayed in different units of the power and voltages. Therefore, we have to change the units in order to make it easily understandable. For this purpose, click on this button and keep pressing on it. It will display another small toolbar. Now click on this V button. Now again click on this button and keep pressing it. Again it will display another small toolbar. Now click on this M to represent the measurement in megawatt and MVAR respectively. It may be noted that in the results still units are not mentioned. Therefore it is difficult to understand these results. For this purpose click on this unit to represent all the measurements in their respective units. Now to zoom it further, go to this zoom button and click here on the screen. Friends, it may be noted that almost all the results are correct. However, select bus voltage is showing 100%, whereas it must show 105%. It is because our per unit voltage is 1.05, which in percentage equals to 105%. Therefore, do these changes in the system as shown here in order to get this 105% at the select bus. You can see now the voltage at select bus is correct. Now compare the results of select bus real and reactive power with the example answer. You can see both the results are correct. It may be noted that bus 2 and bus 3 shows the voltage magnitudes only. However, we also need phase angle measurements at both buses. Therefore, click on this display option. A new window will appear. It shows various options to include in the model. To include the phase angle, just click on this angle option. Then click on apply and press OK. You can see now it has included the phase angle at all buses of the model. Now compare the results of the voltage magnitude and phase angle at bus 2 and 3 with the example answer. You can see both the results are correct. Now we need to include the line losses in the model. For this purpose, again click on this display button. A new window will appear. In this window, click on these branch losses to include real and reactive power losses in the transmission lines. Then click on apply and press OK. You can see now it has included the real and reactive power losses in the various transmission lines of the model. Now compare the results of power flows, line losses of the whole model with the example answer. You can see all the results are correct. Friends, for your convenience, I have uploaded this ETAP model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You just need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be opened which contains the ETAP model of this load flow analysis example. Now click on this button to download this folder. Now click on start download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Now click on open folder to see the location of this folder. Now right click on it and click on cut and bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it. Or create new folder, give it any name of your choice and paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the PDF file as well as ETAP model. Now to open it in ETAP software correctly, go to ETAP software, go to file, click on open project and bring it from the location where you have saved it. Click OK. Click OK again. Wait for a few seconds so that software completely opens the model. You can see it has opened the model here. Now you can run the simulation as discussed in this video. You can see it is working fine. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.